السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. All praise belong to Allah, Lord of the worlds. I ask Him to shower His peace, blessings and mercy upon our dear and beloved Prophet Muhammad, His family, companions, followers, upon all of us gathered here in His blessed house, upon all those who are watching or will watch from home or elsewhere, and upon the ummah of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Dear brothers and sisters, as we are studying the beautiful hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, where he says, سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ. Seven categories of people Allah shades in His shade of His mercy on a day where there is no shade but His. إِمَامٌ عَادِلٌ, a just ruler or leader. شَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ, a young person who is raised in the worship and obedience of Allah. وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ, and a person whose heart longs and is always connected with the masajid. وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّ فِي اللَّهِ جِتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ وَتَفَرَّقَ عَلَيْهِ, and two people who love one another for the sake of Allah, they get together in His obedience and for His sake, and they depart also for His obedience and His sake. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم إن الله تعالى يقول يوم القيامة أين المتحابون بجلالي اليوم أظلهم في ظلي يوم لا ظل إلا ظلي. This hadith is recorded in Muslim. Where are those who love one another for my sake? I will shade them in my special shade, where there is no shade but my shade. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم والذي نفسي بيده صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم لا تدخلوا الجنة حتى تؤمنوا ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ رَوَاهُ مُسْلِمٌ. Abu Hurayrah, may Allah be pleased with him, says that the Messenger of Allah, peace and blessings be upon him, said, by the one who holds my soul in his hand, this is a qasam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is affirming, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَىٰ صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُهُ عَلَيْهِ, meaning by Allah, لا تدخلوا الجنة حتى تؤمنوا. You will not enter Jannah until you believe. ولا تؤمنوا حتى تحابوا. And you are not true believers. You are not believers until you love one another for the sake of Allah. Until you love one another. أولا أدلكم على شيء إذا فعلتموه تحاببتم. Shall I tell you about something? If you do it, it will increase the love amongst you. You will love one another. أَفْشُ السَّلَامَ بَيْنَكُمْ, greet one another openly with salam. Greet one another openly with salam. You know, if someone is sitting next to you and you don't know them, by just having the prophetic tradition of smiling genuinely and saying السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته, that automatically builds the first step towards what's to come next. But if we come and we only say salam to our close friends, but not to the person praying next to us, not to the newcomer, the sisters or the brothers, you know, their children, if we don't do the salam, then everything else is artificial. The very basic is the greeting. If we can't give each other genuine, proper greetings, then to expect any further expectations is almost in vain. So it's very important that Muslims are close to one another. They genuinely care, and it starts and in practice and is manifested by the first step, which is to greet one another with salam, and that would increase the love and that would get us to Jannah. Because when the ummah loves one another, that gets them to Jannah. And when the ummah loves one another, they will never harm each other. No one harms the one they love. And therefore the ummah would be stronger and better in many shapes. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال أو عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم أن رجلا زار أخا له في قرية أخرى. Abu Huraira, may Allah be pleased with him, says that the Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him, said that a man visited a brother of his, I mean not biological brother, but a Muslim brother, a brother, another person, a friend of his. أن رجلا زار أخا له في قرية أخرى. This man visited another man in another village. فأرصد الله له على مدرجته ملكا. Allah جل وعلا sent an angel in human form on the road or path to that village. فلما أتى عليه قال أين تريد. When this man approached this angel in human form, which Allah has sent to him in his path, the angel asked the man, where are you heading? قال أريد أخا لي في هذه القرية. He said, I'm heading to visit a brother of mine in that village. قال هل لك عليه من نعمة تربها عليه. He says, do you have a favor that you are returning to him? You know, sometimes we have this where someone does something for you and we feel obligated to do something back. And that is okay, من باب وإذا حييتم بتحية فحيوا بأحسن منها أو ردوها. This is okay from the perspective of where Allah says, and if you are greeted with a greeting, greet back or return the greeting or with a better, more beautiful greeting, or at the very least, this equal greeting. People use the greeting one another, not necessarily only verbal. Sometimes they greet each other and they give each other gifts. And that is okay. But to only feel, to have that interaction or transaction without much love, that's where it is not recommended. We need to have that love, that genuine care. We shouldn't just do transactions while we really don't care for the person. No, we should try to do transactions and we increase that care and love that we have for one another. So this angel asks, do you have any favor for that purpose you are going to visit him or return? Does he owe you any favor? قال لا غير أني أحببته في الله تعالى. The man said, no, I don't have any favors that I'm returning for him, except that I love him for the sake of Allah. قال, the angel said, فإني رسول الله إليك بأن الله قد أحبك كما أحببته فيه. He said, the angel said, I am the messenger of Allah or from Allah to you. And I am here to inform you that Allah has surely loved you as you have loved your brother for his sake. And this hadith أخرجه الترمذي وصححه الألباني. This hadith is a sound hadith in Tirmidhi, and Sheikh al-Albani proofed that hadith. These three ahadith, along with the original hadith that we are studying about the topic of loving one another for the sake of Allah Jalla wa Ala, this is not a light matter. This is a matter that would get us to Jannah. This is a matter, by having this love, everything else after that is going to be bringing goodness for Muslims and shielding them from harm. That is the natural reaction of anyone who loves another. Many of you are parents. If you're not parents, you have siblings. You have parents. You have friends. You will, if you love your children or family or anyone, I don't question your love for them, but if you have love for anyone, there's no doubt that you would want everything good for them. You'd want them to have the best lifestyle, best colleges, best spouses, best success. We would want everything good for them. And if you know there's a harm coming to them and you are certain of it, you would protect them. And sometimes you would stand in the way of that harm. That same love, if we have for the ummah, this is about loving one another for the sake of Allah, not for anything else. If we have that love for the ummah, then we would always shield them from anything that is harmful. And we would always wish for them and exert an effort to bring everything good to the ummah. And these are ahadith that encourage us to do so, and by doing so, what happens? The virtue of which you are in the shade of the Arshul Rahman on the Day of Judgment. Everybody else in the hadith we studied before, everybody else is worried and shook and scared and frightened, and these people, لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. And inshaAllah ta'ala, next Wednesday, I have two ahadith to share with you. And inshaAllah ta'ala, when you hear them, it is going to bring more detail and pleasure to your hearts as it did to mine. InshaAllah ta'ala, and then we will move on to the next segment and category, inshaAllah. Before I conclude, I would like to take a moment to let you know that we have a dear brother, Brother Kevin Marshall. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him Jannatul Firdaus. He's a young 47-year-old African-American brother. One of the most pleasant people I've ever met. He always had a smile from ear to ear when I saw him. Whenever I saw him in the masjid, he had his nice kufi, big smile, and he would give you a hug, and he would say, I love you for the sake of Allah, brother. I love you for the sake of Allah. And sadly, Brother Kevin passed away yesterday. And he, while he was in the hospital, sent me some text messages. And at first he said, Shaykh, I'm going to the hospital. And Shaykh, they're putting me on a ventilator. I will not be able to text you for the next few days. But inshaAllah ta'ala, pray for me. And once I come out, we're going to go to Sheba together. And sadly, he didn't survive. But Allah Jalla wa'ala has his plan for him. And we pray that he is in a better place with better company and better friends. And I ask Allah Jalla wa'ala to pardon all of his shortcomings. And I ask Allah Jalla wa'ala to forgive his sins. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to elevate his status. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make his soul in illiyin. مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا اللهم اغفر له وارحمه وعافه واعف عنه وتجاوز عن سيئاته ووسع مدخله وأكرم نزله وارفع درجاته اللهم اغسله بالماء والثلج والبرد اللهم اجعل روحه في عليين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا اللهم إنا نشهدك أن ما رأينا منه إلا كل خير وأنه كان دائما متبسما وأنه كان دائما يتلفظ بكل كلام طيب اللهم إنا نشهدك أنه كان مؤدبا محترما اللهم احشره مع النبيين ومع أصحاب الخصال الفاضلة اللهم اجعل حبنا فيك شفيعا له يا رب العالمين واجعله في ظلك يوم لا ظل إلا ظلك اللهم اجعله من الذين هم لا يحزنون لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون اللهم صبر أهله اللهم اربط على قلوبهم اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا صغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنثانا اللهم من أحيته منا فأحيه على الإسلام ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإيمان اللهم اجعل خير أيامنا أواخرها وخير أعمالنا خواتمها واجعل آخر كلامنا من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله اللهم ارحم والدينا ووالدي والدينا ومعلمينا ومن له حق علينا رب ارحمهم كما ربونا صغارا اللهم ارحم ميتنا وزوج أيمنا وارزق عقيمنا واشف مريضنا اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم يا فارج الهم ويا كاشف الغم، فرج اللهم هم المهمومين في كل مكان، ونفس كرب المكروبين في كل مكان، وأصلح أحوالنا وأحوال المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من الهم والحزن، ونعوذ بك من العجز والكسل، ونعوذ بك من الجبن والبخل، ونعوذ بك من غلبة الدين وقهر الرجال. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث، أصلح لنا شأننا كله، ولا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا ولا إلى غيرك طرفة عين. اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من البرص والجذام والجنون وسيء الأسقام. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. ربنا آتنا من لدنك رحمة وهيئ لنا من أمرنا رشدا. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا وحبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. جزاكم الله خيرا. إن شاء الله تعالى his janazah will be here after the first Jumu'ah. His janazah will be here after the first Jumu'ah, inshaAllah ta'ala. I believe he's the only Muslim in his family. I was speaking with his mother today. She's not Muslim. And he used to bring his niece who was a teenager and she wasn't Muslim. And I believe he's the only Muslim from his family to my knowledge. And I hope that we all, if we can join his janazah and join his burial and give condolences to his family, inshaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have many people pray for us and may Allah accept their prayers. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.